Now we are going to learn how to draw the radiograms for concave lens. Concave lenses are diverging type of lenses. Now here also we have three rules to draw the radiograms for the concave lenses. First of all, we need to draw the principal axis. So on the principal axis we have to mark the points. So O is the optical center. Now we have to take the ruler and we have to mark the points F1 and 2F1 and F2 and 2F2 on the principal axis. Here the distance between these two points, these all the points is equal. Yes, you can observe here we are taking the distance between all these points is 2 centimeters. Yes, here for concave lenses F1 and F2 are on opposite side. So F1, 2F1 on right side and F2 and 2F2 are left side. Now, rules for image formation of concave lens. Rule 1, a ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis after refraction appears to be coming from the focus. So you can see here the incident ray is, this light ray is parallel to the principal axis. So after refraction appears to be coming from the focus. You can see here. So after refraction it is appears to be coming to the focus. Now rule 2. A ray of light going towards the optical center of a concave lens goes straight through without being deviated. Okay, this is the rule 2. And rule 3. A ray of light going towards the focus after refraction becomes parallel to the principal axis. Yes, so this ray of light is going towards the focus. So after refraction it is parallel to the principal axis. So these are the three rules to draw the radiograms for the concave lenses. So here you can see the rule 1 and rule 3. These two are opposite, quietly opposite, right? So this is due to reversibility of light. So similarly for concave lenses also we have to choose a 2 out of the 3 rules to draw the ray diagrams. Now first case, here object beyond 2F2. When we are taking the object at a beyond 2F2, now where the image will be formed? Now see, here we are taking rule 1. We know rule 1 is tells us about when the light ray is parallel to the principal axis after refraction, it is passes through the focus. It is coming to be from the focus. You can see here. So after refraction, it is appears to be coming from the focus. Now draw the another ray diagram. Now when the ray is passing through the optical center, it is moves in a straight path, the light ray will not deviate here. So now where the image will be formed? Yes, you can see here the intersection of the these two light rays at this point the image is formed. So this is the head of the image. Yes, here we are passing the light ray from the head of the object. So here we got the image is also upright. So what are the rules for this image? The image is virtual and upright. Yes, and the image is diminished. That means here the object height and image height are not equal. Yes, the image height is less than the object height. And here it is formed between object and lens. What is the position of the image? It is between object. This is the object and this is the lens. This is the position of the image. So the position of the image is between object and lens, and the it is virtual and upright and diminished. This is the case 1. Now see the case 2. Now when we take the object between F2 and 2F2. Yes, so when we draw the ray diagrams, we will observe the same image is at same position. And the properties of the image are same. That is virtual and upright, diminished, formed between object and lens. Yes. So here it is easy to study about concave lens, because we are taking the object on the in front of the lens. So the way the image will be formed here, the image will be formed between the object and lens. So the image is virtual image, and always the image is upright and diminished. The position of the image is at same place. Where we are taking the object on the principal axis, the image position is always same. Yes, so in all cases we will observe the image position is same and the properties of the image are equal. Yes, so we will observe the different cases in convex lenses. And here three questions for you